I am your maths teacher for today and we are going to discuss the topic of division. What is division? Division is a very important arithmetic operation and you usually also use it in your daily lives as well. Let me give you an example. You have 10 candies and you want to share those 10 candies among 5 of your friends. How will you distribute them? What will you do? You will give each of your friends exactly 2 candies. Yes. So what you did over here is you divided 10 of your candies among 5 of your friends. So, with this we conclude what is division? Division is the splitting of a number or a thing into equal parts, or you can also say that division is the process of fair share. Okay, so there are several ways in which we can represent a division sum. We are going to look at 3 ways in which we are going to represent a division sum. The first one is we can represent the division sum using the sign of division. This is the sign of division. We can represent a division sum using this sign. We can write the sum as 10 divided by 5. The second way in which we can represent a division sum is by writing it in the form of a fraction. We can write the sum as 10 by 5. And the third way in which we can represent a division sum is by writing it in the house. We can write the sum as 10 divided by 5. These are the 3 ways in which we can represent a division sum. You can use any of these 3 ways and represent a division sum. Today we are going to solve the exercise number 1C on page number 15. I am going to solve part A of question number 12. The part A of question number 12 is as you can see, I am using a scale to draw the lines. You should do the same so that your lines are straight and your work looks neat. So the question 12 part A is 432,561 divided by 24. There are some terms that we use to represent the numbers written inside and outside the house. The number that I have written inside the house and the number which is to be divided is called the dividend. What is dividend? Dividend is the number that we write inside the house and the number which is to be divided. And the number that is written outside the house which divides the dividend is called the divisor. What is a divisor? It is the number that is written outside the house and which divides the dividend. Okay, so the dividend is a variable number. It is a 6-digit number and the divisor is a 2-digit number. What we will do, because the divisor is a 2-digit number, we will be dividing only 2 digits of the dividend. Okay, we are going to divide 43 by 24. Okay, I know that the multiplying 24 by different numbers becomes very difficult and is also lengthy. So I am going to tell you a very simple trick. What you can do over here is you can take the first number of the dividend and divide it and the first number of your dividend. Now read the table of 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. You have to read the table until you get the number or a number that is smaller than 4. Okay, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. Let's multiply 24 with 2. 24, we'll multiply 24 with 2. 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4. 24 multiplied by 2 is 48. You can see over here we are dividing 43, but 48 is greater than 43. The one rule of division is we cannot divide the dividend with a number greater than the dividend. We always have to divide it with a number that is less than the dividend or equal to the dividend. 48, because it's greater than 43 over here, we are not going to use this. We are going to use the previous number, which is 1. We multiply 24 with 1. We know that if we multiply 1 with any number, we get the same number as answer. So 24 ones would be 24. Okay. 24 ones is 24. The next step in division is we subtract the answers. Okay. 3 minus 4 is not possible because cost 3 is less than 4, what we will do over here is, we'll take a borrow from 4. Over here, just 3 will be left, and over here, this 3 will become 13. Now, 13 minus 4 is 9. And 3 minus 2 is 1. So, over here, the remainder over here is 19. Because 19 is less than 24, we can say that we are doing it correct until now. The next step after subtraction is, we will take the next number down. The next number we have is 2. One very important thing, is the placement of the quotient. You can see over here, I have divided the two digit number by 24. So I have written the quotient exactly above 3. I have written 1 exactly above 3. Okay, now the number over here is 192. We'll use the same trick. We'll take the first number of the divisor and the first number of the dividend. But you can see over here that the number 1 is less than 2, and because 1 does not come in the table of 2, all the numbers that are in the table of 2 are greater than 1. So what we are going to do over here, we'll take the number 19. Using the same trick, read the table of 2 to get 19 or a number that is smaller than 19. Read the table of 2. Yes, 2 9s are 18 and 2 10s are 20. We cannot use 20 because it is greater than 19. So we'll use the number 9. Let's multiply 24 with 9. 9 4s are 36. 9 2s are 18. 19, 20, 21. So the answer we have is 216. But 216 is greater than 192. We cannot use this, so we'll use the previous number to 9, which is 8. Exactly in the same way, because I have just taken 2 down, so I will write 8 exact. Let's multiply 24 with 8. 8 4s are 32. 8 2s are 16, 17, 18, 19, 192. So we remember the rule of division. What is it? That we can write the number that is equal to or less than the number, the dividend. So 192 is exactly equal to the number we have over here. So we can use 8. So I have just taken down 2, so I will write 8 exactly above 2. 24 8s are 192. So again we will subtract the 2 values. Use the scale to draw the lines. Okay, 192 minus 192, 2 minus 2, 0, 9 minus 9, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. It is up to you, you can write a single 0 or 3 zeros because we know that 0 has no value. So we can write just a single 0 or 3 zeros over here, it will have no effect on our answer. Okay, the remainder over here is 0, again it is less than 24, that means we are doing it correct until now. The next step, again we will take the next number down, which is 5. The dividend we have now is 5 and the divisor is 24. We remember the rule of division, we cannot write the number which is greater than the dividend. We have to write a number which is less than the dividend or equal to the dividend. Because 24, 1 0 is 24, which is greater than 5. So there is a number that is before 1, which is 0. So we are going to multiply 24 with 0. 24 zeros are 0. You can multiply 0 with any number and you will get 0 as your answer. Subtract 0 from 5. 5 minus 0 is 5. Moving on to the next step, which is again we will take the next number down, which is 6. 6. Now the number we have in the dividend is 56. Using the same method again, we will multiply 2 with a number. We will take one number from the divisor and one number from the dividend. Now read the table of 2 to get 5 or a number that is less than 5. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Because 2 3s are 6 is greater than 5, we are going to use 2 2s are 4. As you can see over here, I have already multiplied 24 by 2, which is 48. So let's write 24, 2s are 48. You can again see I have written 2 exactly above 6. Now subtract 48 from 56. Okay, 6 is less than 8. We cannot subtract it. We'll take a borrow from 5. 5 will become 4. 6 will become 16. 16 minus 8 is 8. And 4 minus 4 is 0. Because our remainder over here is less than the divisor, we'll take the next number down, which is 1 and which is also our last number. The last number is 81, which makes our dividend 80. The last number is 1, which makes our dividend 81. Okay, again, read the table of 2 to get 8 or a number that is less than 8. We know that 2 4s are 8, so let's multiply 24 with 4. 24 multiplied by 4. 4 4s are 16, 1 carry. 4 2s are 8 plus 1, 9. 96, because it's greater than 81, we cannot use this, so we'll use the previous number, which is 3. Let's multiply 24 with 3. 3 4s are 12. 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. 72 is less than 81, so we'll use 3. I'll write 3 exactly above 1. 24 3s are 72. Subtracting the two numbers, one again is smaller than 2, so we'll take a carry borrow. 11 minus 12, 2 is 9. 7 minus 7 is 0. 9 is less than 24, and we also don't have any other number next to 1, which means that 9, this is our answer. There are other terms which we use to represent the answer. The answer that we write above the house is called the quotient. It is the answer to our division sum, and we write it above the house. And the leftover part, which is the remaining part, is called the remainder. As you can also see that it name indicates that it is the remaining part and it's left behind. Ms. Shahida will continue with the next example.
Good morning and assalamu alaikum. My name is Shahida Sarfaraz and I am your maths teacher of grade 5. Today my topic of explanation is division. As you know that division is one of the basic mathematical operations which we are using in our daily life to deal with different mathematical problems. In your compound book, you have given the long division sums. You can solve these long division sums by following these easy steps. The first step is to divide the number. The second step is to multiply the divisor. The third step is to subtract. The fourth step is to bring down the next number. And the fifth step is repeat these steps. If there is a number that is left over and that is further going to be divided with the divisor. In your compound book, exercise number 1, see on page number 15, there is a question number 12, D part. I am explaining you this sum by following these easy steps. I have written that the question is 650,678 and it is divided by 485. The number that is written inside of the Julian house is called the Julian, and the number that is written outside of the Julian house is called divisor. Or the number that is going to be divided is called dividend, and the number by which we are dividing the dividend is called divisor. You can see our divisor is 3-digit number 485. So as our dividend is 6-digit number, we will not divide the 6-digit number at once. First we take the first 3 digits from the dividend and we will divide with divisor. We have 650. We have to multiply the divisor with some number to get the number that is very nearer to this number and that is lesser from this number. If I multiply 485 with 2 times, I will get the bigger number from 650. But I have to write the smaller number. I will multiply 485 once a 485. Now, our next step is to subtract this number. I cannot subtract 5 from 0. What should I do? I'll take 1, borrow. Add 4 is left here. 10 minus 5 is 5. I cannot subtract 8 from 4. So I will take 1, borrow. And 5 is left here. 14 minus 8 is 6. And 5 minus 4 is 1. Now I have 165. The next step is to bring down the next number. That is 6. Now we have 1656. We have to multiply 485 with some number to get this number, or the number that is very nearer to this number. It will be very difficult to multiply 485 with different numbers. I will give you a very easy and simple trick. You have to take the first two digits from the divisor, dividend, and the first digit from the divisor. 16. 4 fours are 16. If you will multiply 485 with 16, you will get the number that is bigger than from this number. So now we are clear that we have to multiply 485 with the number that comes before 4. We have to multiply 485 with 3. 5 threes are 15. 1 will be taken as carry. 8 threes are 24 plus 1, 25. And 2 will be taken carry. 4 threes are 12. 12 plus 2, 14. Now we have 485 threes are 1455. Now we will subtract this number. 6 minus 5 1, 5 minus 5 0, and 6 minus 4 is 2. We have to bring down the next number, that is 7. Now we have 2017 in our dividend. Again we have to multiply 485 with some number to get the number that is very nearer to but smaller than this number. 4 fours are 16 and 4 fives are 20. If you will multiply 485 with 5, you will get the bigger number. So I will multiply 485 with 4. 5 fours are 20, 0, 2 will be taken as carry. 8 fours are 32, 32 plus 2, 34. 3 will be taken as carry. 4 fours are 16, 16 plus 3, 19. So when we will multiply 485 with 4, we have 1940. Now we will subtract this number again. 7 minus 0 is 7. I will take 1 borrow, it will become 10. And again I will take 1 borrow, it will become 11. 11 minus 4 is 7. 9 will be left here. 9 minus 9 is 0. And 1 minus 1 is 0. As you know that when we are writing the 0 at the start of a whole number, it has no value. So there is no need to write the 0 at the start of a whole number. Bring down the next number from the dividend. That is it. Now we have 778. As you know students, 4 one time ones are 4. Here is 7. 4 ones are 4. That is very nearer to 7. So I will multiply 485 ones are 485. Now I will subtract this number. 8 minus 5 is 3. I cannot subtract 8 from 7. I will take 1 borrow. 17 minus 8 is 9. 6 will left here. 6 minus 4 is 2. We have 293 left over here. You can see there is no number in the dividend right now. So we have completed our division sum. The number that is left over after division process is called the remainder. And the answer we are getting from this division sum is called quotient. One more thing about the placement, the correct placement of quotient is that if you are solving the 3-digit number, like this, first I have divided 650, it is a 3-digit number. So I am writing the first number from the quotient above the third number, and then we are moving on. And at the last, you have the last number of the quotient at the last digit of your dividend. So this is the sum of question number 12. Now we will move on to solve one more sum from question number 13. Now students, we have to solve one more sum of 3 and page number 15, exercise number 1. See, question number 13, A part, that is given in your book is 746,028 divided by 38. Whatever the number that is written before this division sign, we are taking this number as dividend. And the number that is written after this division sign, we are taking this number as divisor. I have written this number inside of the division house, 746,028, and I am dividing with 38. I told you before that we are taking, if we have the two digits in the divisor, we will first take the two digits from dividend. We will divide 74 with 38. I have to multiply 38 with some number to get the number that is very nearer to 74, but it should be smaller than 74. Now I have multiplied 38 with 2s. 8 2s are 6. 1 is taken as carry. 3 2s are 6 plus 1 7. 38 2s is 76. But 76 is greater than from 74. So I have multiplied 38 with 1. 38 1s are 38. I cannot subtract 8 from 4. So I have cut down the next number and taken 1 bottom. 14 minus 8 is 6. And 6 is left here. 6 minus 3 is 3. 36. Now I have to bring down the next number, that is 6. 366. I told you the very easy and simple trick that you have to take the first number from the dividend and the first number from the divisor. 3 9s are 27. That is very closer to and nearer to 36. I have multiplied 38 with 9s. 9 8s are 72. 2 is written here. 7 is taken as carry. 9 3s are 27 plus 7, that is 34. Now 38 9s are 342. Now you have to subtract this number. 6 minus 2 is 4. 6 minus 4 is 2. Now bring down the next number. That is 0. 240. Now multiply 38 with some number to get a number that is less than 240, but it should be very nearer to this number. I have multiplied 38 with 6. 8 6 is 48. 8 is written here. 4 is taken as carry. 6 3 is 18. 18 plus 4 is 22. So 228 is a very appropriate number. I have multiplied 38 with 6 is 228. Now subtract this number. You cannot subtract 8 from 10, 8 from 0. So you have to take 1 borrow. 10 minus 8 is 2. 3 was left here. 3 minus 2, 1. Now bring down the next number, that is 2. 122. Again, I have to multiply 38 with some number. I have multiplied 38 with 3. 8 3s are 24. 4 is written here. 2 is taken as carry. 3 3s are 9 plus 2, 11. 38 3s are 148. Now subtract this number, cut down the 2 and bring the, and take 1 borrow. 12 minus 4 is 8 and 1 minus 1 is 0. There is no need to write the 0 at the start of a whole number and bring down the 8. Now we have 88. 38 2 times is 76, as we have multiplied before. 8 plus 16, 6 and 1 carry. 3 plus 6 plus 1, 76. Now again subtract this number. 8 minus 6 is 2 and 8 minus 7 is 1. 12 is left here and there is no more number in the dividend. So we have completed our dividend sum over here. 12 is the remainder and our quotient is 19,632. This is all about long dividend. The rest of the part I am giving you for homework practice. Thank you so much.